My name is Marisa. I'm one of the instructors here at SPENGA Tucson. I also have instructor Kylie with me today. If you haven't been in studio with us before for a SPENGA workout, we do 20 minutes of spin, 20 minutes of strength, and 20 minutes of yoga, all combined together for the best workout ever. Today, I'm going to take you through a nice 20-minute revive sesh, so our yoga flow. So when you're ready, grab your mat or whatever you like to work on. If you have a block or any other sort of props that you like to use, feel free to get them. Get into something comfortable and let's get working. One more thing before we get going. I created a specialized playlist just for y'all for this workout. You can find it on my Instagram, which will be listed below in the description box. Kylie's info as well as all of SPENGA Tucson's social medias will be there as well. So let's get ready to work. Today we are going to start all the way up at the top of our mats. I want your feet hip-width apart, so about the width of your fist between those big toes. Engage your abs, relax the shoulders, and stand up as tall as you can. Take this time to claim your space on your mat. Own it. You deserve to be here. This is your time. Let's take a big breath in, drawing those arms up overhead. Exhale, take it through heart center. Two more just like that. Inhale, big reach. Exhale, heart center. One more, inhale. And exhale, heart center. This time, we big reach to the ceiling. We're gonna go all the way to our toes. Arms come out like a T on our exhale. Down to the mat. Inhale, hands come up to the shins, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, full fold. Inhale, we're stepping both feet back into a nice high plank. Kylie over here is gonna show us an alternative option for our yogi flows. So when we're ready, we're all gonna come halfway down into a yoga push-up. Inhale, flip those toes up, dog. Exhale, tucking the toes, hips send up, down dog. Inhale, look forward between the hands. Step both feet forward, forward fold. On your next inhale, arms reach up overhead. Nice big stretch to the sky. Exhaling, hands at heart center. We're gonna do three more just like that. So inhale, take the arms up. Exhale, hands to the toes. Inhale, halfway lift, shoulders roll up and back. Exhale, full fold. Inhale, step both feet back, high plank. Option to drop the knees. Exhale, let's take our yogi push-up. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, look forward between those fingertips. Step both feet up. Exhale into that fold. Inhale, reach to the sky. And exhale, hands at heart center. Good, two more. Inhale, take the arms up. Exhale, down to those toes. Beautiful, Kylie, beautiful at home. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, full fold, find your reach. Inhale, step both feet back, taking it into that high plank. Good. Exhale, we're gonna yogi push up no matter where we're at. Good, inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog, send the hips back. Inhale, look forward between the palms. Step it on up. Exhale, into your fold, nice full fold. Inhale, reaching the arms back up to the ceiling. And exhaling, hands at heart center. Last one, best one. Inhale, reach. Exhale, full fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, full fold. Inhale, we're stepping both feet back, high plank. Take it nice and slow into that yogi push-up. Exhale. Inhale, up dog. Chest rises. Thighs up off the mat. And exhale, down dog. Send it back. Take a second here to walk your dog. So bending one knee and then the other, shifting through the heels as you stretch out the backs of those legs. Really press the chest down towards the mat and relax the ears and shoulders away from each other. Inhale, we'll look forward between those palms. Step it on up. Exhale to fold.
Take a gentle bend behind those knees and go ahead and grab opposite elbows here for ragdoll. You can find a little sway side to side or a nod, yes or no. Really stretching through our vertebra, creating space, becoming more open. Enjoying these moments that we have of stillness between our flow. When you're ready, go ahead and drop both arms down to the mat. I want you to take a nice slow roll all the way up to stand. Slow, 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 beautiful, vertebra by vertebra. When you reach the top, the arms reach up. No rush, take your time, this is your practice. And we'll all meet with hands at heart center. From here, we're gonna stay at the top of our mat, but I want you to go ahead and bring your feet a little bit wider out at a slight angle. We're gonna take it down into a yogi squat by sending the hips back and really sinking into our heels. If your heels peel up off the mat here, that's a-okay, work with what you got. If we have the room, I want you to draw the elbows to the inside of those knees, palms come to heart center. Send the shoulders down the spine so our chest is as proud and tall as you can make it. Drop your chin down to chest, relax the back of the neck. And we're gonna take about four nice big breaths here. Giving our body a chance to open through the hips, create space. This is where we hold a lot of our migrational low back pain, is from our hips and the tightness there. So here is where we start to work that out. Let's take one more breath right where we're at. And then on your next exhale, I want you to drop both hands down to the mat, and we're gonna step our feet back high plank. As always, option to drop the knees, we're gonna take it through our yogi flow. So half push up, inhale up dog, and exhale, down dog. Take a nice slow walk up to those fingertips, working our way into our forward fold. And then on your next inhale, we'll take it back up to high mountain. Arms reach overhead, exhaling hands. So from here, I want you to bring all of your weight into your left foot. Hands can stay at heart center or come to the hips for a little bit more stability. So all of our weight is in that right. Our left knee is going to rise up 90 degrees at the hip. From here, we're going to send it back into airplane. So engage the core, start to shift forward, legs go back first. Arms follow when you are ready. Flexing through that up leg. Our left toes are down, heel up towards the ceiling. Inhale, coming back up to stand. Knee comes all the way up. Hands return to hips. And exhale, we drop it down. Shake out that bottom leg. Whew. And let's switch it out. So this time we're gonna take it on to the left leg. So I'm not mirroring you right now, so don't do the same leg twice here. Rise through the right knee. As you're ready, start to shift those hips back, send the legs straight, flex the toes, arms shoot back, airplane. Finding our stability here. Inhale, slowly start to hinge your way back on up, knee comes back up. Exhale, we take it back down, shake out that bottom leg. Whew. All right, we're gonna take it back to the other side. So all of our weight in that right foot, hands on the hips or at heart center, whatever feels best for you. Inhale, left knee comes up. This time we're gonna do three in a row, some airplane crunches. Exhale, send it back, finding your airplane as you're ready. Flex the left toes. Inhale, come back up through center. Hands to heart center. Exhale, send it back, airplane. drawing it back up. We've got one more. It's okay if you fall out. Just join right back in. Exhale, send it back. Beautiful. Inhale, back up through center. Last time on this leg. Exhale, drop that left leg down. Shake that right out. Ooh, a little bit spicy. All right. Last time here. All of our weights in that left leg. Hands are on our hips. Right knee comes on up. Exhale, shift it through, sending the right leg back. Toes are flexed, arms reach. Good. Take it back up through center. Knee comes up, hands to heart center. Exhale, send it back. Work with your body as a hinge. Inhale, draw it up. Balance comes over time. You are all capable. Let's send it back one more time. Inhale, draw it back on up. Exhale, drop those legs down. Dance it out, shake it out. You are doing a beautiful job at home. Stick with us here. Let's step back up to the top of our mats if we lost that. Inhale into high mountain. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, shoulders roll up and back. Exhale, full fold. Inhale, step both feet back, high plank. Option to run through your yogi flow or send it into down dog. And we'll all meet together in down dog, walking those heels, creating space through the backs of our legs. On your next inhale, right leg reaches up and back, flex the toes, three-legged dog. Exhale, we're gonna step that foot to the outside edge of our mat, coming into lizard. So you can stay here with your knee up, or you can drop it down to the mat, untuck those toes. Plant the left hand down into the mat, inhale, right arm reaches up and open. Press those hips forward, so we are getting a nice big stretch here. Exhale, right hand comes down. Place it on the inside of the right leg. Make contact all the way from wrist up to shoulder if you can. And we're gonna inhale, left arm reaches on up. Find the space. Exhale, back down through center. Tuck those left toes behind you. And we're gonna send that right leg up and back, three-legged dog. Exhale, back down to the mat. Inhale, left leg reaches up and back. Three-legged dog, flex those toes. Exhale, step it all the way forward, outside edge of our mat. Both hands on the inside of the foot. Option to drop the right knee down, untuck those toes. Our right hand is gonna plant in here this time. Inhale, left arm reaches up and open. Nice big T. Staying strong and stable through our back, finding that twist through the center of the spine. Exhale, left arm comes down. Make contact with the left arm inside that left leg. And when you're ready, right fingertips float up in the air, opening through the chest, breathing nice and deep. So even when I'm not cueing you to breathe, I want you to take that initiative, big belly breaths in through the center. Exhale, right arm comes down. Inhale, we're gonna send that left leg up and back, three-legged dog, beautiful. When you're ready, left toes come back down to the mat. Last option for our yogi flow here. So shift those hips forward, take that half push-up, inhale through up dog, and exhale into down dog. Go ahead and drop both of the knees down onto the mat. We're gonna take the knees out as wide as the mat, the big toes together, and send those hips back for child's pose. Four nice big breaths here, really filling up the belly, breathing into your upper back, that upper spine, creating space through the ribs to expand.
It's amazing when you start to pay attention to your breath, you realize all of these places that we hold little bits of tension that when you expand through the torso, you can help to release.
Let's take three more nice big breaths here. Really enjoying this pose, shifting those hips back as far as you can, melting the chest down, 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 and relaxing through all of the muscles of the face, neck, and shoulders. When you're ready, start to walk those hands back towards the body. We're going to send the hips back onto the heels, working our way onto our spines in any way that feels good for you. So I'm going to shift off to the side. You can cross one ankle over the other. Everybody who's been in class with me before knows I love a good challenge. So we're going to take the heels all the way up to the top of the mat, flexing those toes. And I want you all at home to go as slow as you can go to get yourself back down on the mat. So arms come straight out from our shoulders, plug the shoulders into the spine, really flex through those toes, engage your core, and how slow can you go? Taking our time, maybe a little shimmy. Have some fun with it. Enjoy it. I know it may seem silly, but you're allowed to have fun during yoga. You're allowed to have fun when you work out. It doesn't all need to be serious and intense. We can get a good sweat while we giggle. Ooh, today is feeling spicy. All right, I'm gonna flop right on down. If you need a little more time, go ahead and take it. Let's place our hands by our sides, palms face down, and bring the heels to the mat, knees bent. Take a second to windshield wiper your knees side to side. Big breaths here still. And then when you're ready, I want you to take the right foot and put it in the center of the mat and take your left leg, cross it all the way over, maybe tucking those toes under the calf if you can. Mine don't quite reach, but that's okay. When you're ready, palms are gonna come face up at your sides, out like a T, and we're gonna drop both knees over to the right. Your chin can drop gently to the left, or it can stay in neutral if that feels better for the back of your neck today. Start to slow everything down, enjoying the spinal twist. Allowing yourself to have permission to close your eyes, relax the muscles of your face. Inhale back through center. Unlace those feet. Plant both of the heels into the mat and give the hips a little lift just to reset the spine. Let's take the left foot and bring it to the center of your mat. Right foot is going to cross all the way over the left leg, and then we're going to drop everything off to the left. Maybe the gaze over to the right with our eyes closed, if that feels good for you today. Allow yourself to enjoy this stillness. Inhale, let's come back through center. Bring both of those heels back to the mat, a little baby lift through the hips. And send both legs out nice and long on the mat. Palms are coming face up at our sides for corpse pose.
today we're going to do a little bit of active tension release as our final relaxation. So wherever you're at, close your eyes and take a nice big exhale for me, letting go of all of the breath in your body. Inhale and rise your right foot about 2 inches up off the mat. Flex your foot. Squeeze and tense all of the muscles in that leg as hard as you can. Point your toes and exhale, release. Inhale, we'll rise the left foot about 2 inches. Flex your foot. Squeeze and tense all of those muscles as hard as you can. Point your toes. And exhale, release. Inhale, engage your glutes, squeeze them tight. And exhale, release. Inhale, breathe into your belly, swell your belly out like a balloon, pressing against the abdominal wall. And exhale, release. Inhale, rise your right hand about 2 inches up off the mat. Make a fist. Squeeze and tense all of the muscles in that arm as hard as you can. Spread your fingers wide. Exhale, release. Inhale, we'll rise the left hand. Make a fist. Squeeze and tense all of those muscles. Spread your fingers wide. Exhale, release. Inhale, make a sour face. Draw all of the muscles of your face in together towards your nose. Squeeze everything as tightly as you can. And exhale, release. Inhale, take a big breath in, the biggest breath you've taken so far today. Open your mouth and sigh it out. Inhale even deeper and sigh it out. Last one, inhale and sigh it out. Now just for a moment, allow your body to be absolutely still. Let go of all thoughts, worries, and concerns as we spend just the next few moments in silent meditation. Begin to find a little wiggle in your fingers and your toes. Start to deepen your awareness of your breath and every part of your body that is touching the mat underneath you. In your own time, roll off to your right side and spend a couple of breaths there. Then gently work your way up to any comfortable, easy seat so we can end our session together. We'll sit up nice and tall one last time. We'll draw our hands together at heart center. We're closing all of our beautiful homework classes with a little bit of positive news. So mine today is that I got fully approved for the new townhouse that I'm moving into. All of the paperwork was just finalized yesterday, and I am super excited about it. So I hope every single one of you have an absolutely beautiful week or weekend whenever you are watching this video, and Kylie and I both thank you so much for joining us.